force. Of these open buildings, 83% showed evidence of illegal use by prostitutes, drug dealers, property criminals, and others. This building and others like it bring down property values, increase crime, and cost the community not only in dollars but in respect. This is how people see Maywood. We want to change that. Introducing rhythm, putting soul back into food. The combination of good down-home cooking and the blues is an incredibly delicious mix. This is what rhythm will bring to Maywood. A warm, inviting atmosphere, perfect for an afternoon lunch or a nice sit-down dinner. We will take an expensive, dangerous blight on the community and turn it into a wonderful multi-use location to be enjoyed by all. After enjoying the wonderful meal at Rhythm, step into Blues School and educate yourself with some of Chicago's best local and national musicians playing live nightly. The ability to record live audio and video will make Blues School a very attractive venue for top blues performers from around the state and the nation. The top floor of the building will house the recording control room and corporate offices. Most of the upper floor will house the Shirley King Blues Museum. The museum will tell the story of Chicago and the blues, with interactive displays, sound and video booths, and live weekend performances. We will provide Maywood with a cultural, educational, and entertaining destination for the whole family. Thank you for your time, and we look forward to you joining us in taking this big step in the revitalization of Maywood.
I'm on board. I want to be the mayor.
Crime rates on blocks with abandoned buildings are 2 times as high as those without.
Will you join me in making a change here in town? What I would like to do is form some committees. I can't do it by myself. That's why I want to form some committees. I have 5 committees that I would like to get started in this town. One committee would be the Thoroughfare Committee. The Thoroughfare Committee would be a committee that would, in fact, concentrate on the thoroughfare. The thoroughfare is very important. I know when I moved to Maywood 40 years ago, I drove down the thoroughfare, the main streets, and I looked at the tree line, and this is a nice looking town. And after moving in town, they used to plow the sidewalks. I said, this is great. But as I moved in, I saw people moving out eventually. And when I saw people moving out, eventually the service began to decline. I moved in over on 17th Avenue. It was a narrow street, 17th Avenue. It had potholes in the street. But that wasn't too bad. So my family and I, we moved in that area. So I told my wife, I said, you know, we can do something about this. Formed the block club. The block club went from the expressway to Maywood Drive. 90 families was involved. 116 children, if I can remember. 116 kids. 90 families. It wasn't just one block. Usually a block consists of about 30 people. This block was 3 blocks. We all got together and we met. We put lights in the yard. That made the whole area look better. We began to have our monthly meetings. We talked about enlarging the streets or widening the street. But when we talked about widening the street, most people was on board. But we found out it's not an easy task to do that. Because you know why? The state is involved in it. It's a state route. So we worked with our trustees, we worked with the mayor, and the streets was never widened. So it's okay, we're gonna take another approach. An approach that I hate to take, but I am not a weak person. I'm a strong little man. So I said, well, this is what we're gonna do. And the people behind me said, let's do it. I said, we're gonna stop the rip off and we're gonna start the rope off. I said, Gardner, what do you mean by that? I said, we're gonna preserve what we got. I said, we're gonna go down on Harrison Street, that's the beginning of 17th Avenue. So anybody coming off the expressway, we're gonna have a rope, roping off that street. And the only people can come on 17th Avenue are those who live there, are those who are coming to visit someone who live there. That's a good idea. And you know the next step that we took? We made signs. We made signs. And we put signs in everybody's yard. Stop the rip off, start the rope off. Stop the rip off, start the rope off. So now you got these lights in the streets, in the yards, and now you see all these signs out there in everybody's yard. Stop the rip off, start the rope off. One morning I was laying there in the bed and my wife came and woke me up. She said, Jim, look out the window. I looked out the window and there's a great big bulldozer sitting in the front of my house. One of those things that tear up the streets. It sit there for a little while. I said, oh good, maybe they're gonna start widening the street. It sit there for about 2 weeks. Nothing happened. They sit it there at a time when we was gonna start roping off the street. That was to hush me up. I called the, we're gonna go ahead and start the rope off. And when they saw that we was gonna do it, you know what happened? My wife didn't wake me up. I heard the jackhammer out there, tearing up the streets. And the next thing I knew, they was widening the street. Sometimes you have to take that action. You can talk, you can talk, you can talk. But you have to take action sometimes. We are free today more so because when Rosa Parks said, hey, I'm not going to get up, I'm going to sit here. Then the movement started. Sometimes you have to do that. And that's what we have to do in Maywood. We have to let our village manager know. And I met with him a week ago. He knew about the five committees that I want to start. The thoroughfare committee, ladies and gentlemen, is a very important committee because that committee is going to take note of every property on the main street. And we collectively is going to meet with people who can bring about the change. That report that the thoroughfare committee get, they will give it to me, and I will then meet with the village manager. But I know I got that support system. I can then get back with the thoroughfare committee because they're the ones that gave me the report. Under the Freedom of Information Act, we can get all the information we need. I got other committees, the residential committee, the residential property committee. We got many, many foreclosures in this town.